Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited today. สวัสดีค่ะทุกๆคนขอต้อนรับเข้าสู่น้องช่อง YouTube นะคะเพิ่งเริ่มทำค่ะยังไงฝาก subscribe กดไลค์กดแชร์ด้วยนะคะ I want to show you how I make kimchi at home. Also we're gonna make kimchi fried rice today. I'm so excited. This recipe is inspired by other YouTuber Monkey Thumbs Up. Thank you for your inspiration. I love your channel. So I have been practice her recipe at home and I love it. I added some of my sister twist. I hope you enjoy the recipe. Step one to make the kimchi, we're gonna cut the napa cabbage. Step two, we're gonna make the porridge. Step three, we're gonna layer the porridge into the cabbage that we cut. And this is the fun part. And then after that, we're gonna make kimchi fried rice. All right, ready? Let's make some kimchi, guys. So first, you're gonna cut it right here in the middle, like that. But you don't go it all the way, okay? Just that much. And then you're gonna use your finger and split it. Like that. All right, see, it's very nice. And then we're gonna do it same on this side. I'm just gonna cut it like that. Not all the way, and then I'm gonna split it. So we are trying to make the best kimchi. Like Korean housewife, even though we are not Korean housewife, but everybody can be Korean housewife, okay? Just like that. And then next step, we're gonna salt the napa cabbage. Basically, you try to get in the salt into all the layer of the cabbage. And then this way, the cabbage will release its own juice. The store bought, they don't do this part because we make our own kimchi and this kimchi is gonna be excellent. So you wanna make sure you put all the salt, a lot of salt into this layer. So don't worry that it's gonna be too salty. When you put the cabbage in the bowl, you wanna place the cabbage this angle because you want the water came down in the bowl. But if you put it this way, the water stay right here. So you place it this way so the water go into the bowl. We gonna leave it for 20 minutes and then we gonna flip it. We're gonna flip it like that every 20 minutes for about 2 to 3 hours. You can see the color and the cabbage is kind of shrink because it release its own water. This is the water that come out from its own cabbage. I didn't add any water. So now we're gonna rinse the cabbage that was in the salt water. So now we're gonna make the porridge for the kimchi. So we're gonna make it on the stove top. I just turn the heat on. I'm gonna put it on low and I'm gonna add, this is 2 cups of water, 2 tablespoons of sugar, 2 tablespoons of rice flour, and then mix it together in low heat. It will take a few minutes for the water to heat up. You don't have to stir it all the time, but just make sure that the flour is melted with your water. We're gonna turn the heat off and let it cool down. Now we're gonna make another part of the kimchi sauce. So I'm gonna do it in a blender. We're gonna put garlic, fish sauce, ginger. I love ginger. Onion. This is dry shrimp. If you go to the Asian grocery store, it should be in the frozen section. Yes. And then I see this, I have this little apple here too. I'm gonna I'm gonna add it into my kimchi sauce too. I think it's gonna add some sweetness to the sauce. And then I'm gonna blend it. I'm gonna use everything that's in the blender into the partridge here. Smell really good. I can smell the apple too. And we have a lot of apples where we are in Oregon. It's my little twist. I like spicy. You can put less, but I really like spicy one. Hot. I'm Thai, so I'm gonna add this is about 2 cups of Korean dry chili flakes. I can smell the chili already. Next part, we're gonna add the green onion, the carrots, and the daikon. I love daikon. I like to put chives in my kimchi, but I don't have it today. So I have this green apple right here. I think I'm gonna cut it and add it into my kimchi too. All right, so I'm gonna add this into the mixture. I recommend use the gloves. The first time I didn't use the gloves, my hand was on fire. Even though I'm used to it, but when you have the gloves, I recommend it. Okay, so now this mixture is nice, beautiful. Look at all the colors. I love it. Now is the fun part. We're gonna put the kimchi together. This kimchi mixture that you made, I'm gonna add it into this kimchi. So I'm gonna put try to put all in all the little socket of all the cabbage. I don't have the clay pot, but we're gonna use this Tupperware that you have. And then you want to layer it up in this angle, so all the kimchi mixture is stay inside. Just this part of the process is very relaxing, and it smells really good too. So I'm gonna not pack it and put it all the way to the top because I want to leave room, because after it ferment, it gonna release all the juice. So this is gonna be all liquid. So I want to leave some room for it. I'm gonna add a little bit of more of the mixture on top here, because I have a lot of the mixture. And after we finish this kimchi, we're gonna make kimchi fried rice. Now your kimchi is in a container. You want to leave at room temperature for about 6 hours. And after that, you can put in a fridge. I have some kimchi that I already made from yesterday. And now let's see what's inside. So it smells really, really good. That's why I told you to leave the space, because all this juice, so it won't overflow the container. And you see all this bubble, it's a fermented process. Now we're gonna cut it, and I'm gonna use the gloves to cut it one more time. Beautiful. Cut it like that. And we're gonna use this kimchi, and we're gonna make kimchi fried rice. It's really easy, guys, and I think you're gonna like it when you know how easy it is. So first, we're gonna make it on the stove top in a wok. I like to cook on high heat. And first thing I'm gonna put sesame oil, garlic in there, shallots. It's already smell really good. Oh, I forgot one thing. I like to add some gochujang into my fried rice too. So this is the Korean chili paste. I just obsessed with this ingredient, but it will make a cooking a little bit tougher because it's very sticky. I'm gonna add some rice in there, this rice. And rice from yesterday is even better if you guys have old rice. And then I'm gonna add the kimchi that we made. This is the fresh kimchi. It's already good on itself, but if you feel like fried rice, this is gonna be the bomb. I'm gonna add a little bit of nong sauce. Just a little bit of sugar. Look at how pretty it is. And to make it even more extra pretty, I'm gonna add some fried egg on top. Kimchi fried rice, easy to make. I hope you enjoy the recipe, and I hope I inspire you to cook some food. If you like what you see, give us some love, hit like, and click the subscribe button. สวัสดีค่ะ